but I can't go into all that. I'm just getting my clown thing right now. Might as well get this one, because this is a good one. Get Saul. Oh, read 1 Chronicles 27 and 19.
1 Chronicles 27 and 19.
Uh-huh.
Of Zebulun, Ishmael, the son of
Obadiah. Oh, no, no. I'm sorry. It has to be something else there. No. I don't need it then. It's okay. I was going to do something that's really nice, but if it ain't there, I ain't doing it. It's the last verse of 20. I don't care. No, we ain't going there. Get Psalms 80. 80 verse 1. We'll bring that out another time.
Psalms 80 verse 1. Give ear, O shepherd of Israel, thou that leadest Joseph like a flock, thou that dwellest between the cherubims.
Thou that dwellest between the cherubims.
Shine forth.
Shine forth. Because there was what they called the Shekinah, or the Shekinah, the high priest, and there was a great vision of Yahweh, and that's him shining forth. And you know what Shekinah means? It means Yahweh dwells. Showing that's where he dwells. He's supposed to be dwelling in you. You understand? Okay. 17 of Matthew, it'll say, then went up Peter, James, and John.
Right.
Well, you better read.
Matthew 17 and 1. And after 6 days, Yahshua taketh Peter, James, and John, his brother, and bringeth them up into an high
mountain. Now, why does he take Peter, James, and John up to a high mountain? Because he took Aaron, Nadab, and Abihu up into a high mountain. See, Peter, James, and John are the first three ministers that go send out to preach the gospel. And Aaron, Nadab, and Abihu are the first three ministers in the tabernacle. Aaron's the high priest, and Nadab and Abihu are the low priests.
Right.
Also, Aaron's the oldest, Peter's the oldest. Nadab and Abihu are brother, James and John are brother. He's fulfilling the scriptures. So he takes them up to a high mountain. What does he do?
And was transfigured before them.
He transfigured before them. What does transfigure mean? It means he changed figures. Read.
And his face did shine as the sun.
His face shined as the sun, because that's the true, that's the creator. He's showing that spirit body. Read.
And his raiment was white as the
his
light.
His raiment was as white as the light. Wasn't this the body of heaven in his clearness? Is light clear? He's fulfilling the scriptures. He's proven he's the Messiah. If you don't know how to go back there, you don't know what he's doing in Matthew. Read.
And behold, there appeared unto them Moses and Elijah.
Why is a Moses and Elijah appearing there? Because it's likened unto a high mountain, it's likened unto the most holy place with the two archangels. That's what Moses and Elijah is representing there. Read.
Then answered Peter and said unto Yahshua.
Okay, can't do it. Get the fifth verse.
Verse 5.
No, you better keep reading it. Then answered Peter. Isn't it good for us to be here?
If thou wilt.
Let us make here three tabernacles. Too late, brother. it ain't time to make no tabernacle. You want to make one for Yahshua, one for Moses, let's make here three tabernacles.
Yeah.
No way. We're fulfilling. We ain't instituting. But he mentions tabernacle because back here when Yahweh Elohim appeared, he told him to build the tabernacle. So when he appears back, so when he sees the vision back here, he's going to talk about a tabernacle. Read.
Verse 5. While he yet spake, behold, a bright cloud.
Oh, what's this cloud doing there? Huh? Oh, bright cloud appeared. Huh? Yeah. You think when he sends up in the cloud, that's the first time. Why does the cloud have to appear? Because he said in Leviticus 16:2, he would dwell in the cloud between the wings of the cherubs. Read.
Yes, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and behold.
And see that cloud? Wasn't that cloud of fire back here? Bright cloud. Read.
And behold, a voice out of the cloud, which said, "This is my beloved son."
This is my beloved son.
In whom I am.
Elohim's the word or son. So they saw a vision of Yahweh Elohim. Yahshua Messiah showed that's who he is. This, and he, the voice in the cloud, "This is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased." Read.
Hear ye him.
Hear ye him. Read.
And when the disciples heard it, they fell on their face.
When the disciples heard it, they fell on their face. And why is there 12 disciples? Because there were 12 tribes of Israel back here. Read on.
And were sore afraid.
They're afraid. Read.
And Yahshua came and touched them and said, "Arise and be not afraid."
Read.
And when they had lifted up their eyes, they saw no man save Yahshua.
Okay, ninth verse.
Verse 9. And as they came down from the mountain, Yahshua charged them, saying, "Tell the vision."
Tell the vision.
To no man.
To no man.
Until the Son of Man be risen again from the dead.
Till the Son of Man be risen again. Why did he tell them, tell the vision, no man? Now, you know what? If you had 3 disciples and Yahshua showed him that great vision to you, you don't think you'd tell the other 9 what Yahshua showed me? Well, he had to black it out of their minds, just like he blacked out of here. They built a golden calf. They didn't even build no man. They should have built a golden man. But he said, "Tell the vision to no man until after the Son of Man be risen again." Joshua had to bring him back to remember what they saw after he rose from the dead. Tell the vision. So it's a vision they're having to the Son of Man. And so the vision... A vision with a bright cloud back here. Yahshua talks about a vision with a cloud back here. So when he ascends there, Acts 1:9, read it. And see, when he resurrects, he's going to resurrect the spirit body. When he appeared at that transfiguration, he's showing he really has a spirit body. And that's what we're wanting you to see. He's really a spirit body. If the Father is spirit, the Son has to be spirit. You know the Holy Spirit is spirit. Where do you get the flesh up in there? But that's what people think. Jesus went up into a cloud. Well, I tell you what, you go 5 miles up there, there's no oxygen. Jesus would have fell down dead. Plus, when they say he goes way up there, when he comes back, he's going to be burned up. Because you know when them spaceships come back, they re-enter the atmosphere, they burn up if they ain't got a heat shield on them. You know them guys couldn't even go to the moon.
That's right.
Without oxygen.
Right.
So you think you're going to have physical bodies going up there?
No.
Plus, 1 Corinthians 15:50 says flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom.
Right.
And he's the king of the kingdom, so he couldn't be fleshly. We want you to think down here. And we didn't know either. I was just as blind as anybody else in here. I was a fool in a pair of shoes when I walked in here. You all beat me out. I didn't even know nothing. I mean, I didn't even own a Bible at the time. Didn't care about one. But I had to go buy one after I came down to class. Because them guys taught a lot of stuff, and I had to check it out, see if they wasn't trying to trick me. All right, get Acts 1:9.
Acts 1:9. And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight.
Now, is that cloud new?
No.
No, matter of fact, that cloud even led them, you understand?
Yeah.
How they got into Canaan's land, they had to have the Ark of the Covenant.
Right.
Lead them, which is showing the head leading you. You understand? So that means there was a cloud leading them clear out of Egypt, through the wilderness, on into Canaan's land.
That's right.
So when you see the Savior, he dies, buries, resurrects. And here it is. It said, then a cloud received them out of her sight. Read.
And while they looked steadfastly towards heaven.
And while they were looking towards heaven, well, when the high priest came up in here and he gave them that Shekinah shine forth, that's a vision that he seen.
Behold.
When they came through the Red Sea, that's a vision they were having. You understand? It's hard to understand, but that's how the Creator appears.
Right.
So when the Savior is ascending, it said there's two men appear. Why two men? Because again, it's the most holy place according to the pattern. So you look at the most holy place and you see the two archangels. That's what the two men are representing. They're two archangels. Read.
Behold, two men stood by them in white apparel.
In white apparel.
Which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand?
And you know what Galilee means? Galilee means circle. And the high priest made a circle up here. So you understand? He went up on this side, come around, made a circle, and backed out. What's that about? Well, we might get that with the scripture lesson. It's in your physical body. You have what's called the arterial circle of Willis. And why would it be called the Willis? Because that's what his will is. He overturns it.
Yeah.
Just like a circle. It's a complete circle. Because when you have a circle, you don't know where it begins and ends. It's continuous. Showing how Yahweh overturns his purpose.
Yeah.
Seven arteries feed the base of your brain with oxygen. That's the arterial circle Willis. Looks like a stick figure of a man in your head region. Showing forth the head of vision of him that's in your body. Read on.
Which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Yahshua which is taken up from you into heaven shall so come in like manner as ye have seen him go.
He's going to come back in like manner as you see him go. You better pick this one up. Because he said the same thing to him when he was physically alive. See, some people don't think the kingdom's come yet. Matter of fact, one of the prayers they prayed in the church I went to, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. I didn't even know what hallowed was. I said that so many times as a kid in church. Hallowed means holy is his name. So when you find out it's Yahweh, you start using that hallowed name. I told my parents that. They didn't care. They just went back to church. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And don't want to use Yahweh. Don't want to use the holy name you're praying to. Then you know what else they say? Thy kingdom come. Oh, that's a big mistake doing that now. Oh, he done changed on me. I'll tell you why. Well, anyway. Oh, I got dispensation here. It's because when he told him to pray, it's before the cross. So you don't say thy kingdom come when it's before the cross, and then you're 2,000 years later praying the same prayer, thy kingdom come. Can't do that. And I'll tell you why. Read Matthew 16:28. But you have to read the King James Version.
Matthew 16:28. Verily.
Well, you can read the holy name too. But Matthew 16:28.
Verily I say unto you.
Joshua's talking to his disciples. Verily I truly I say unto you.
There be some standing here.
He said, there's some standing here.
Which shall not taste of death.
Which will not taste of death.
Till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom.
Oh, so he's telling his disciples, you're standing here and you will not taste of death. You will not die till you see the Yahshua's kingdom and glory. coming kingdom. That means those guys, that means the kingdom must have come. Because those guys are dead now. So to pray, thy kingdom come, you just said Joshua told them guys a lie. Because he said he wouldn't, them guys wouldn't die till they seen the kingdom come. So the kingdom must have come. Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay. And I'll just give it to you real quick. Romans 14, 17 says the kingdom of Yahweh is not eating and drinking, but it's righteous peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. So when the Holy Spirit poured out, that's when the kingdom came on earth. Okay, so there those guys fishing. They said, the same as you see Yahshua go. Oh, if you have the holy name, it'll say, until you see a vision of his kingdom glory. Why does it say vision? Because that's what they saw when they saw him ascend out of a cloud. It was a vision. And said the same Yahshua will come back in like manner. He came back as a revelation with the Holy Spirit. That's the clapping. You know it says in Acts 1 and 5 before the 1, 9 and 10. See, it said he'll come back in like manner. Well, if you say he hadn't come back yet, then those two men lied to him. He came back 10 days later as the Holy Spirit. And that's what Acts 1 and 5 said. Acts 1 and 5 says,
John truly
baptized with water.
But he shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days hence.
And it was 10 days later. And that's when he poured out the Holy Spirit, and that's when he filled their tabernacles or filled their cloud. That's when the cloud covered it and the glory filled it. Yep. So they saw out. Boy, there's so much to talk about. I'm gonna get the scripture lesson though. I tell you what, you see how tall the Pegasus is up there? You're reading a scripture lesson that you're gonna meet Jesus in the cloud, right? I bet you get to the top of the Pegasus and Jesus says, come here. Are you going to go, okay. They're going to read about, I'll read about you in the gleaner. Man fell from the Pegasus and is dead. You understand? All right. Let's get the scripture lesson because this is what they call the rapture. We're going to try to cover it. I'd like to go to Revelation. Well, it depends which one you want me to do.
4:14. For if we believe that Yahshua died and rose again.
If we believe that Yahshua died and rose again, and you don't have nobody knowing that Jesus rose again. If he rose again, that means it happened before. That's another lecture. We can prove he rose again. Read on.
Even so, them also which sleep in Yahshua will he bring with him.
Him that sleepeth in it, the dead ones, are he's going to bring with him. Read.
For this we say unto you by the word of Yahweh, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Savior shall not prevent them which are asleep.
Well, of course you're not going to prevent them that are asleep. Because you ain't got no power over all them souls that Yahshua's resurrected. You understand? Read on.
For Yahshua himself shall descend from heaven with a shout.
Okay. Now, you read in the Bible. Well, by the pattern, you have a death, burial, resurrection, ascension. So Yahshua would be in the most holy place. Because he said he sat on the right hand of the Father. So it says, Yahshua is going to descend from heaven, that'd be the most holy place, with a shout. Now why has he got a shout? Because when you go to Joshua the 6th chapter, they went around Jericho 6 days circling Jericho. And on the 7th day, they went around 7 times, and they shouted, and the wall came tumbling down. That's in the most holy place. So that's why it says shout.
Right.
Read.
Descending from heaven.
And you can go to Revelation 8 and correlate it with Joshua 6. Read with the first trumpet. Read.
For Yahshua himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel.
Ah, with the voice of a what?
The archangel.
An archangel. See, there's archangels in the most holy place, so you know where it is according to the pattern. Right. If you don't have a pattern, you're just reading the Bible. Oh, he's going to come with a shout. Yeah, yeah, church. He'll come with a shout and the voice of an archangel. Did you hear what the Bible said, church? That's what the word say, church. But they ain't show you nothing. They ain't show you got no archangel in no most holy place on the Ark of the Covenant. They just read you the Bible with the voice of an archangel. Because you'll read in Numbers 789 that Yahweh said that he heard the voice of Yahweh from between the wings of the cherubs. Read.
And with the trumpet of Yahweh.
And with the trumpet of Yahweh. And you wouldn't know why I had no trumpet neither. But if you go back here, when he spoke that law down, it said that his voice was as exceedingly loud as a trumpet. Over here, when John saw him, it said his voice was as the voice of a trumpet, exceedingly loud. What's that about? Because when he appears, he's going to... See, when he poured out the Holy Spirit, those guys went out preaching, and the fifth feast day is a feast of trumpets. So they went and preached the gospel, Yahshua Messiah. And in your mouth, you have what's called the buccinator muscle, which means trumpet.
Right.
Oh, yeah, I bet your pastor told you that would do it, didn't he?
No.
Wow. And then now we're down here at the end of this age. We're ready to go into the fifth age, so the fifth feast day. It started out with the trumpet, preaching the gospel. So he's going to say, with the trumpet of Yahweh. And you know what? When over here in Jericho, when they shouted, the priest with seven trumpets blew the trumpet. And in Revelation, you got seven trumpets. Yeah. Yeah, you can't do it. And that's when the walls fell down, when the trumpet and the shout. Read the next verse.
Yes.
So we're correlating the things in the law and the prophets with this. You can disagree with what I say, but ain't nobody disproving what we say down here. Somebody say, why are you speaking so loud? Well, I tell you what, if your house was on fire, would you want me to go?
That was all right.
No, man, you can go to the lake of fire if you don't understand what we say down here. If your house on fire, you better come on here and learn something about Yahshua Messiah.
All right.
Read.
And the dead in the Messiah shall rise first.
The dead in Messiah. Why does it say the dead in the Messiah shall rise first? Because when he's descending from the most holy place, the first thing he comes to is the altar of incense.
Right.
Read Revelation 6 and 9. This is the fifth seal. So the fifth seal is telling you about the fifth step. The gate's the first step. The altar's the second. The laver's third. The door's fourth. The holy place is the fifth step. So here's the fifth seal. Read it, please.
And when he had opened the fifth seal.
When he opened the fifth seal.
I saw under the altar the soul.
I saw under the altar. It's the altar of incense, not the altar of burnt offering. Read.
The souls of them that were slain for the word of
the
Yahweh.
The souls had been slain for the word of Yahweh. They're dead, aren't they?
And for the testimony.
They died physically, but they're alive spiritually through Yahshua. Read.
And for the testimony which they held.
The testimony they held. Read.
And they cried with a loud voice, saying, how long?
How these guys crying if they're dead? Yeah. Showing you can speak in the spirit. Read.
How long, O Yahweh, holy and true, dost thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth?
Uh-huh.
And white robes were given unto every one of them.
Why white robes? Because when he resurrected them, he's got to clothe them with the spirit. So that they can get their immortal glorified body at the same time as everybody else. But if you're going by the pattern, that's why when he said the dead in the Messiah will raise first. Well, who is the other? How? Well, that's the scripture lesson. Keep reading there in Thessalonians.
Verse 17 of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with him in the clouds.
And do you know where you are? Where you're supposed to be? Matthew 24, this is why we preach the gospel. Matthew 24, 14, verse 15. It said in this gospel of the kingdom. See, we're preaching about the kingdom, buddy. That's why we know the kingdom's come. Not gonna come. And you know what? You can't be in the kingdom and don't know what the king's name is.
That's right.
Jesus.
You know it said there shall be gnashing and wailing and gnashing of teeth? You can't say Jesus without gnashing your teeth. Jesus. Read on.
Yes, then we which are alive and remain shall be caught.
And we which alive remain. Why? Because Matthew 24, 14 says, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached. And the gospel is how Yahshua died, buried, resurrected. So when you preach the death, burial, resurrection, the blood, water, spirit, that's how it gets you into the holy place. That's how you get anointed. You get to stand in the holy place.
Right.
What are you standing on? Standing on the gospel of Yahshua Messiah. You understand? And ain't nobody moving. You understand? Because we're rooted and grounded in the truth. So it says, in this gospel the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for witness unto all nations, then shall the end come. When you therefore see the abomination, desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet, stand in the holy place. So just where those guys, the altar of incense is in the holy place, so are you in the holy place. So he's going to gather you together same time. It isn't going to be different times, but it's saying that according to the pattern. How do you know that? Because I got Hebrews 11:39. Read that.
Hebrews 11:39.
Another reason I gotta speak loud, them people way back there gotta hear what I got to say. Read. Or what Yahshua got to say. Read.
And these all, having obtained a good report through faith.
He's talking about all those guys by faith, Abel. By faith, Enoch. By faith, Abram. By faith, Noah. By faith, Moses. By faith, all them prophets. You understand? He said, all these.
Having obtained a good report.
They retained a good report.
Through faith. Received not the promise.
They didn't get the promise of eternal life yet. Read.
Elohim having provided some better thing for us.
This better thing for us. There's something better than this physical. That's eternal life, an immortal glorified body. No pain, no suffering, no crying. No going back to work, no paying bills. Read.
That they without us should not be made.
They without us should not be made perfect. That means it has to happen at the same time, that perfection. But the way Paul was doing it, he's going by a pattern when he said that he's going to descend from the heaven as a shout of a voice of an archangel. And they the dead rise first, and then we which remain shall be caught up with them. And it says in the what? In the air. The air represents the spirit. The air is not the spirit, but it's invisible and you need it and it's in you. You understand? It surrounds you and it's in you. It's representing Yahweh. Your walk, you're within. It's within him that we live, move, and have our being, and he's in you, giving you life. Read. And he gave you your physical life was a gift, and he's given you eternal life if you believe it. And you get enough proof down here. You can't know everything we teach just coming every once in a while. Or you're new. You just have to keep coming back because that's how we learn. Kept coming back. Because you never know what you're going to get down here. But the truth, you know you'll get the truth, but you don't know what we're going to get into. Yeah. Read.
To meet Yahshua in the air, and so shall we ever be with him.
Ever be with him. Read.
Wherefore, comfort one another.
Now he said comfort one another for the words. You know why there's a second Thessalonians?
Right.
Because that wasn't comforting.
Yeah.
He said we're going to meet him in the air. We're always going to be in the air. And everybody they saw fall in the air died. And they're saying, I don't understand that, meeting him in the air.
Right.
Because that air ain't holding nobody. You fall off the tree, you fall off the high tower, and they die. You understand? So that's why he wrote 2 Thessalonians. Because the 1 Thessalonians, it troubled him. So that's why Second Thessalonians, the other part of it.
2 Thessalonians 1:7. And to you who are troubled.
See, these things can trouble you. Because they're spiritual things, and you're trying to figure it out. You got a lying preacher talking to you. And you're wondering whether the lying preacher's right or whether you should leave church or not. Yeah, you ought to run out of that church. Read. But you can compare. If you compare what you hear here to a church, no comparison. Read.
And to you who are troubled, rest with us.
Rest with us. Why are you resting? Because Yahshua did all the work. Read.
When Yahshua, the Messiah, shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels.
Oh, wonder who them mighty angels are. That's the bodies that you received when he captured you up. Anybody that's in the holy place is going to get an immortal, glorified body or an angelic body. And what happens is, it's time to appear to all them people that are not. See, look at here. See, the labor's like unto a lake, and the altar's like unto fire. So if you hadn't made it into the holy place, you're going to be consumed in the lake of fire. So it says, when Yahshua Messiah shall appear from heaven with his mighty angels, you better hope you're one of them. Read.
In flaming fire.
In flaming fire.
Taking vengeance on them that know not
He's
Yahweh.
He's taking vengeance on them that know not Yahweh. That means you didn't get resurrected. You're dead and buried in the court round about. You understand? Read.
And that obey not the gospel.
And you obey not the gospel.
Of our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah.
Of our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah.
Who shall be punished with everlasting destruction.
Yeah.
From the presence of Yahweh.
That's right.
And from the glory of his power. When he shall come to be glorified in his Son.
Yes.
And to be admired in all them that believe. Because our testimony among you was believed in that
was
day.
Was believed in that day. Read.
Wherefore also we pray always for you, that our Elohim would count you worthy of this calling.
Yeah, count you worthy of this calling. He's calling you into the kingdom. You best be coming. Read.
And fulfill all the good pleasure of his goodness.
Yeah, he's got some great things. You understand? They asked him what eternal life was like. He said, think about the happiest time you have. You can multiply by 100,000. It don't matter. You can multiply by a big number. It's better than that. It's worth it. Know the truth. The truth will make you free. Then they asked him what eternal damnation was like. He said, it's like a migraine headache throughout eternity. You don't even want that for minutes. You want that for eternity? It's worth coming and learning about Yahshua. Read.
And the work of faith with Paul, that the name of our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah, may be glorified in you.
The name must matter, huh?
That's right.
May the Yahshua Messiah be glorified in you.
In you and in him, according to the grace of our Elohim.
Oh, wow.
And our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah.
We don't have no more time, huh? You know, we love going to more stuff. I got the book of Revelation waiting on us. But I guess that's for another class.
Yeah.
We're glad that you came. Boy, it'd be nice to see you there Tuesday like this. And Thursday. We have group classes then too. But anyway, we're glad you came. You can only come on Sunday, glad you came. Please come back. You understand? Because Yahweh will bless you through his son, Yahshua the Messiah. This is a beautiful teaching. And ain't nobody teach like this. Dr. Gideon, you say, if you find somebody teaching something better, at least tell me so I can go there. He knew there wasn't nothing no better. Matter of fact, he said, look, if you find it, if you can disprove what we say, we'll burn the charts up and follow you. Well, it ain't happened yet and ain't going to.
That's right.
This is the truth. He said, I boast in Yahweh and he backs me up. We say that too. We boast in Yahshua and he backs us up. Because this ain't us.
Nope.
Like I told you all, I was over there preaching down there in Spanish Town under the light pole by the, well, that time I think we was by the railroad station. And I was telling how we were formed from the dust of the ground. That's why we got different colored dust. You understand? Because we're formed from dust and ground. Some guy asked a question. Well, why we got different types of hair? I didn't know the answer to that. I say, because Yahweh purposed it. Well, yeah, that's easy to say. Then Yahweh showed him. Because you got different types of grass growing out of the ground. That's why you got different types of hair, and that's what I told him. I said, you know, I didn't know the answer to that. So I'm like, it's like a ventriloquist. This is a dummy up here. But the spirit can speak through the dummy. It ain't really the dummy, it's really the spirit. But you're looking at the skin and hair. Skin and hair ain't doing nothing. It's the Creator, hopefully, the Holy Spirit teaching through people. See? And it's marvelous. It's a beautiful thing. And so we love you. We hope you come back. Come to the seminar if you want. We got some other brothers coming in for that. You know, you've seen Rowan Ross and Bonnie. There's another guy from Hartford coming. Well, anyway, all praise go to Yahweh El, to his son, Yahshua Messiah. Hallelujah.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
We have been announcing for a couple of weeks now that our annual seminar will be on the 11th and the 12th of February at Champion College, starting at 10 o'clock to 6 o'clock each day. And we expect everybody to be here. Also, we are setting cash out kind towards the wonderful Spanish loan is cooking for everybody on Saturday. So if you have anything to donate, we'll accept it. You can send the treasurer after.
Shave them.
Omar. Thank you for coming. And we hope you come again to study with us. Classes resume here at the corner of Ellis and Young Street every Tuesday and Thursday from 7:30 p.m. to 9 p.m. Every Sunday from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. In Kingston at 94B Old Oak Road every Wednesday from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Friday from 6 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. And every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. Let us stand for our doctor.